Hey guys, it's Huff. I am back again, and this is going to be a tag video. Sorry about the funny angle, and if the light is a little weird, I already filmed one video. The sun is like right there, and yeah, I had to wear sunglasses, and I thought, well, I'll just change my angle a little bit. So I'm a little bit in shadow, but hopefully it won't be quite as bad as the way too much light thing. So this tag is the My Makeup Journey tag, and I am actually going to be doing this in collab with a whole bunch of other people. I know one of them is Cassie, I think Steph and Cara are doing it as well, but everybody that is doing it will be linked down below. So make sure you go and check them all out. The creator of this was Annette's Makeup Corner, which I don't know her, I don't follow her, that's not where I got the tag from. Cassie is the one who said, hey, let's do this tag. And I hadn't done it yet, so I'm pretty sure I haven't. So I thought I'd do it. There are 10 questions. So the first question is, how old were you when you started wearing makeup? Well, I did calisthenics and ballet and stuff when I was like 4 or 5 years old. And so they make you wear makeup when you perform. So there was that. And then I did quite a bit of theatre from sort of towards the end of primary school and quite a long way through, well, all the way through my high school. So I was wearing makeup for that. And I also sort of started wearing makeup, especially to school in high school, in probably year 9 or 10, I think I probably started. So about 14, 15, somewhere around about then. My mother didn't really wear makeup unless it was a special occasion, and my grandmother was a powder and lipstick kind of person. So yeah, it wasn't something that I was surrounded by a lot. It was just something I really enjoyed, especially when I started doing theatre. I quite enjoyed wearing makeup. So number 2. Have you gone through any makeup phases you look back on now and think, WTF was I doing? What the fuck was I doing? No, not really. No, I don't think I ever really had any, like, really crazy phases that I went through. No, not really. I wore quite natural type makeup a lot. Basically, I didn't wear, you know, really thick black eyeliner. I didn't used to use black eyeliner at all. I used brown eyeliner or grey eyeliner for like a really long time. It wasn't until sort of more recently that I wear black eyeliner. Number 4, what was your first high-end purchase? That would be my Lorac Mega Pro. That was the first time I ever bought anything high-end. So, yeah. And I couldn't get the other Mega Pros because they were sold through Ulta. And Ulta doesn't ship internationally. Number 5, what makeup items have you repurchased the most, and how long has it been in your rotation? I don't think there's any. The only thing I have repurchased more than once, or more than twice, is the Australis finishing spray, which smells like rose water, and I really like it. I don't know if it does any good. I don't know if it's a decent setting spray, but I like it, and it's a relatively good price and easy to get hold of. So yeah, I've bought that multiple times. And I've bought the Fit Me Concealer twice. That means it must be good, because normally I don't rebuy things. So yeah, probably not anything. Number six, what does your family and friends think of your makeup obsession? Depends on who you ask. I think my kids think I'm a little weird. My partner is quite supportive, and he just likes to see me happy, so he doesn't really care too much. Most of my friends, I don't even think they're really aware of the extent, except for one, and she likes it because it means that if she needs her makeup done for something, she can come to me and I'll do it, because she doesn't wear makeup at all, except for special occasions, a bit like my mum, really. I don't know, it's not really something we discuss, so, yeah. Number seven, what or who inspires the way you do your makeup? Quite honestly, nobody. I just do what I want, and, like, I watch a lot of YouTubers, and I used to read a lot of books and stuff like that, but I don't necessarily follow anybody in particular and the way that they actually do their makeup. I just do what I like. There's not anybody's style that I am particularly drawn to other than my own, really. And I like to just, you know, play around and see what works, basically, and what doesn't work. And if it doesn't work, that's fine. I just don't do it again, but you learn something from everything. Number eight, describe your current makeup style in three words. Occasional, colourful, fun, I guess? Yeah, I think that would be it. Number nine, what pushed you to start your YouTube channel? I was starting to watch quite a bit of YouTube. I don't even know what started that. I just started watching YouTube, and then I just got more and more drawn into this YouTube world and watching people, and I thought, you know what, I reckon I could do that. And I really wasn't seeing, a lot of people in my age bracket. Like, they all seem to be quite young people, because I'm a little bit older, and I didn't really see too many people who were like me, and there weren't a lot of Australians as well. It's quite a small group of people in Australia. So I don't know, I just thought it would be fun, and it would be different, and push me out of my comfort zone a little bit. And I always liked, like, as I said, I did theatre quite a bit. I liked drama and acting and being in front of an audience, so I guess there was that aspect of it as well. So it was just, I saw other people doing stuff and I thought, I can do that. And I sort of started to become a little bit obsessed with, like, makeup and stuff, and nails, and it just kind of went from there. Number 10, do you think you will still be on YouTube in 3 years from now? That's actually a really hard question to answer, because I'm going to university next year, and I don't know how much time I'm going to have. I mean, I'm still hoping to make videos regularly. I mean, I tend to bulk film anyway. I'll film, like, you know, 5 or 6 videos all at once. It just takes me a while to edit them sometimes. So I'm planning on still being on YouTube in 3 years. I just don't know for sure. And, you know, you don't know what's going to change in the world, what's going to change in your life. I'd like to be. I'd like to be monetized in 3 years. That'd be great. But yeah, I don't really know. As I said, I'd like to be, but who can predict what's going to happen in the future? So that is the makeup journey tag. As I said, other people that I collabed with will be linked down below. Make sure you go and check them out. If you want to subscribe to my channel, click the button down there. Click the little bell if you want to get notified of when I upload new content. Give me a thumbs up if you like tag videos and leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya!